Hi guys, welcome back to the YouTube channel. So it's been a bit of a break. It's just after Christmas. What are we on, the 29th of December? So 2023 is nearly to a close. Little wrap up of what's been going on. So post show, I had 8 weeks of a rebound phase. Pushed my body weight up nice and quick there. Got up to about 260 pounds. Then I went on my honeymoon and melted like a puddle in South Africa because it was super hot. Came back from that, and then unfortunately I've been dealing with a couple of injuries over the last few weeks. I've had a bit of patella tendonitis in my knee, which today being a leg day, I'll show you how I'm treating. And a bit of an impinged shoulder on my right shoulder. Fortunately, everything's freed up now after some physio work and a lot of rehab. And I start the off season on Monday, so I'm going to hit the ground running, feeling nice and fresh. So we're going to get in the last leg day of 2023. Going to do some fun stuff today and give you guys an insight into the kind of training I'm still doing, which is low volume. Quite specific towards my goals, so a lot more quad work than hamstring. But just going to ultimately have a bit of fun before the real work begins on Monday. So starting off with the warm-up, I've already done some static stretching this morning to loosen up, making sure everything's moving properly. And now I'm going to show you a bit of a dynamic mobility work I'm doing to warm up my knees, just to try and make sure they're in a good and healthy position before I start trying to pound them again. So let's have a bit of fun. So starting with, these are some Spanish wall squats. So basically I put a band around something nice and sturdy, go back to the tension on the back of my knees, then squat down and hold it for 30 seconds. This static hold, it's meant to be very good for easing up knee pain, and I've felt the benefits of it since introducing it, so that's how I start every session. After I've done 30 seconds, then I do 10 squats normal, really focusing on tracking my knees out so they're both moving the same, because obviously this is the painful one. If this one's collapsing in like this, it's not moving properly, and then it's going to translate badly onto the squats when I do them, so try and make sure both knees move into the same position as I go up and down. Just do 10 reps like this, and that's those ones done. And I do some, I don't know what these are called, I think they're called bike pumps, I'm not too sure, so I keep the band on the back of one knee, and then toe off the floor, there's plenty of tension there, and I just push my heel to the floor, like that. And when you've got nice and hairy legs, it hurts a lot because it's pulling on all the hairs. And then swap legs, making sure everything's moving as well as it should do. Because even though it's my right knee that's the problem knee, I've also had a little bit of tendonitis in the left knee. Again, just because on prep I was such a low body weight for a long time, off the back of it I gained a lot of weight very quickly and gained a lot of strength very quickly. All the muscles got really tight as a consequence of that. And if you think about it, when a muscle gets tight and it shortens, tendons on either end are going to have to lengthen to compensate for that muscle tightness. Because those tendons have lengthened, they get more prone to getting inflamed, especially if we're trying to continue to push heavy poundages. So I pulled back on the weights that I was using, done more rehab work, making sure everything feels good before I actually try and load anything. Unfortunately for me, that's worked over the last few weeks. Getting way less knee pain. I mean, it was to a point where I'd drive to work, that half hour drive to work, my knee would be killing me during it just because it's bent for the whole time. Obviously, if it's bent, it's lengthened. But now I'm in a good position, getting no pain throughout the day, but still just staying on top of everything, making sure everything moves okay, so I'm not doing anything stupid. So I've done them now. Last thing I do is I do some squats again, but this time banding single leg at a time. Can get plenty of tension on it, heels on the floor, squatting down, and just really avoiding letting anything twist as I squat down. And as you squat down, I can feel it trying to pull my knee forward, so I've just got to try and resist it, making sure everything moves at the same angle. And after that, I just like to do some bodyweight squats again, without the resistance now pulling between my knees, just to make sure everything's moving nice and properly. And already, my knees feel a lot better as I do this movement. I just feel less pain there, feel looser, feel like they're moving properly. So that bodes well going into the session. So this is just a nice deep stretch that I do on the leg press at the beginning of each session. When you come down, you're only gonna get so low, but as you hold it over 30 seconds, you'll see at the end I'm actually a lot deeper than when I started. So look, you can see the end position. Granted, my hips have lifted a little bit, but I feel so much deeper, so much more stretched. So now, so every session like this, I come up, and do a static hold on each leg for 30 seconds. After that's done on each leg, I come up and do 20 pulses, do that on each leg, come down and do 15 full reps. Again, just making sure everything's moving nice and proper. This is the last bit of preparation work I'll do before we start lifting, so everything feels good, and I think today's going to be a good day, which is always dangerous because then I tend to get carried away, especially now the camera's here. But I'll try and keep it relatively chilled. I know that the off-season starts on Monday, and that's when, you know, it's head down, focused on the work. So I already feel my mindset shifting. Obviously, we've just had Christmas, so I've got a ton of motivation to lose a bit of the chocolate weight that's been acquired over the couple of days. But I'm more excited about seeing the progress over the next 18 months, because it's going to be a fun one. So as Caitlyn Jenner would say, buckle up, buckle rouge. Nice South Park reference for you all there. Good old leg extensions to begin with. Staple, isn't it, really? Warm up the quad, making sure everything's moving nice and smooth. And I always feel like the compound stuff moves better if everything's been worked before. So, you know, on the other day I do a bit of hamstring and adductor work. On this one I do a bit of leg extension. When I go onto squats now, I just tend to feel it more. So it's always nice to feel ready to lift heavy. I like this plate-loaded one. The contraction feels super intense. Sweet, warm-up's done. Still just one working set and everything. Low volume, so this is our one working set of 12 to 15. And then what I'll do at the end is partials. So there's a lot of people talking at the moment about lengthened partials being very good for hypertrophy. I think some people are getting a little bit confused as to actually how they should structure it into their training. So I'm just gonna show you the way that I implement them as and when I do. I don't do them on everything. On certain exercises, I think partials are a great way to get a little bit more out of the set. So what I'll do on here is I'll do my working set. As you can see, I come up, I pause at the top, come down, pause at the bottom, get as much as I can out of that. When I can't complete a full rep anymore, what I do is then I come down and continuously try and pump as high as possible on each rep. And obviously, I've just hit failure, so I'm not gonna get super high, but I'm always coming down into that lengthened range and using that full stretch, i.e. using the lengthened partial range to stimulate a little bit more hypertrophy after we've hit failure. So it's just a way of extending the set a little bit. So next up, Cybex hack squat. A machine that a lot of people like to use, becomes very popular because of social media these days. It's a nice angle. It's a nice angle on the plate as well. It's just good for getting really deep and hitting there. As you can see on the first rep, what I do is go all the way down, feel where the bottom of the machine is. After resting for a few seconds, I come up slightly and hold the bottom position. So basically just get my body mechanics working and knowing exactly how I'm gonna move throughout every rep. So as we increase the load, my form is not gonna change, despite, because otherwise what happens is people put on too much weight, the form gets sloppy, next thing you know, you're running a risk of injury and you're not actually training the muscles you want to. I want to get the most out of this with the least. So I don't go super heavy on it at the moment. Try and keep it all super controlled and try and really make the quads work for it. Doing a few more warm-up sets at the moment to make sure everything moves good. Must have said everything moves good about 20 times already. I just hope I move good. Yeah, boy. Feeling good today. Very worrying. Very worrying. Time to get fucked up.
Oh, this is the one, you fucking pussy! Fuck yeah.
Fucking fire alarm. That's the first time doing above four plates since the knee started playing up 8 weeks ago or whenever. A bit longer. Feels good. Feels good to get the blood pressure up again. Cybex squat press next. I like this leg press more than I like the ones on a rail. Just because as it swings, it kind of works more naturally in terms of your alignment, in terms of how your when your legs come down, that weight traveling like that just stays a bit more naturally aligned with how my legs move. It's very hard to get quite deep on a 45 degree leg press, in my opinion, unless you've got really, really good mobility. And then this one helps me kind of get around that issue. Because like I said, it doesn't travel on a straight line, it swings. So as you can see, I can get nice and deep on it. There is a little bit of butt lift off the bottom. You know, I do push a little bit into the toe, but like I said before, if I can use a lighter weight and get the most out of it in terms of muscular growth, I'm gonna opt for that option. I could load tons of weight on this and barely move it. Is that gonna grow my legs? Yeah, maybe. Risk of injury is gonna be way higher. You know, the amount of time it's going to take to the exercise is a lot more, so I'm going to be in the gym a lot longer. More time getting tired on the warm-ups. Instead, I'd rather make something harder than just think automatically add weight. So how's I'm going to do it? Obviously, I'm going to increase the weight from there. I'm doing a working set, 10 to 15. But I'm going to try and do every single rep, nice and deep, really try and get the most out of my legs doing this exercise, rather than just chucking a ton of weight on, not really targeting the muscle groups. That's how deep I go. whereas some people put their feet like this, quite high up, and then they're focusing like this. So their knees are coming towards the head, and I can feel that already on the working more of the back of my legs. Dumbbell split squats. I do these with one hand supported so I don't lose my balance, and I hold the dumbbell outside of the leg I'm working on. I remember seeing John Jewett do it, and he said he just feels it a little bit more on the outer sweep of his quads, which is an area I need to develop. So I copied. Whether it works or not, I don't know, but I kind of like the setup now, so I'm not going to change it. Yeah, they fucking suck. Seated hamstring curls next. So we've done all our quad work. Now we're gonna do one hamstring exercise and then one calf. So I like to do the lying hamstring curl on the other leg day, and then this one I do the seated, just so I'm working it in both positions. One's more stretched than the other. Nice and controlled, really not trying to, you know, we expended a lot of energy. Everything's super warm and a bit fatigued now, so I'm not thinking about trying to jerk the way up and trying to do anything to move it. I'm really trying to lift it with a lot of control, you know, because everything around the hamstring's pretty tired now. So I want to try and focus on the hamstring alone as much as I possibly can. So not going crazy heavy with the weight, but really controlled, squeeze out the contraction, so come down, let it stretch all the way out before going again. You know, try to make it as isolated a movement as possible. Reasons why, way more comfortable on my knees. Again, old man, my knees hate me at the moment. So it's more comfortable on my knees, more comfortable on my hips. And I also get a better pump in my hamstrings if I do it this way. If I try and just chuck a load of weight on, try and throw it back, I'm gonna hurt my joints a lot more than I'm actually gonna hurt my hamstring. And you know, the name of the game is bodybuilding. It's not ego lifting, it's not seeing how much weight you can lift. It's about getting the biggest body you possibly can with the best training principles that work for your body. So, a bit lighter, more control on this. Again, working in a higher rep range, 12 to 15. It's gonna be enough to really hurt anyway, because I'm pretty beat up as it goes. Fuck. three rest pauses on this, 20 seconds each. First set, 15 to 20, rest 20 seconds, max reps. Rest for 20, max reps. Rest for 20, max reps. And then partials at the end. Again, using that lentil partial bullshit that you're going on about. Oh. 3, 2, 1. Oh, fuck you. God, that hurts. That hurts way more than any other calf exercise I've ever done. You know, 15 to 20, all super deep stretches, three rest pauses and then length and partials. If you can't grow your calves, give that a try because it's fucking disgusting. All right, guys, that's leg day done. Last leg day of 2023. So the next time we're filming for YouTube will be the beginning of the off season. So I'll be able to run you through what I'm doing there. Training wise, diet wise, how the next 18 months is going to look up, but it's been a nice end to the my God, I can't even speak, I'm fried, but it's been a good end to a great year. You know, competitively, it was a very good year with my showings. You know, I got married this year, went on my honeymoon, moved house recently, which is why I've been extra busy. Worked on a bunch of cool jobs, so it's been a very good year, but I'm looking forward to 2024 being quite literally the biggest year yet. So thank you for tuning in, guys. Really appreciate you all. Hope you've had a great year and hope you're looking forward towards bigger goals in 2024. I just want to quickly say, if you like coaching advice, feel free to DM me because I am actually opening up my books to online coaching now. So if you're looking to get into shape over the year, you want to build some muscle, you want to lose some fat, feel free to shout out me. I can get back to you. Similarly, if you'd prefer to get some posing coaching, you've got a bodybuilding show coming up, maybe you want to learn a few tips and tricks, feel free to shout out to me again because I'm available for posting coaching as well. Other than that, head to my sponsors, conteh Sports, and grab yourself all the best supplements. Discount code NICA10 on your purchases. Great pre-workouts, great proteins, and loads more range to come over 2024. So yeah, thanks guys. Like and subscribe, all that jazz. Nick Smurf, signing out.